The Frog Who Refused to Croak. By Stephen de Laurier. Once upon a time, a frog named Phobos decided he would become the greatest yodeler the world had ever seen. He bought a guitar at Towers Department Store and practiced day and night. The constant twang drove everyone in the house nuts. While Phobos was sleeping, his dastardly brother Deimos saw the guitar in half. Phobos was a persistent little frog. He glued the guitar back together and kept on playing. During a high school toga party, Phobos was strumming Fire and Rain when someone threw a bucket of water on him. But frogs are hard to drown out. Phobos traveled out west and fought forest fires to make enough money to buy a real guitar. The only number the firefighters would listen to was Talking Forest Firefighting Blues. That was the only song with no yodeling in it. The only good line in the song was the lunches were unbearable. As a matter of fact, the bears would steal him and then bring them back. With a new guitar in one hand and a soapbox in the other, Phobos set off for Smashville to seek his fame and fortune. As he was leaving, his dastardly brother Deimos yelled out, "You'll never make it with a voice like yours." In a vain attempt to improve his voice, Phobos practiced the same shrill voice lesson every day. The sound was so terrible that some piranhas jumped out of their aquarium and chased him down the fire escape, all the while nipping at his heels. Phobos got a gig in his hometown. He rented huge amplifiers, microphones, and loaded everything into a bus during a blizzard. The whole town came out to hear him. In the middle of a song, Dastardly Deimos put a pickle in his mouth and snickered, "This will make you sound better." When Phobos turned up at his parents' doorstep, out of a job, his father took him to the tire factory to get a job. The foreman looked at his matching blue jean jacket, his long riding boots, red bandana, dark glasses and long hair. He slowly shook his head. "No." Finally, Phobos found work with a construction company, operating a jackhammer and learned how to yodel in staccato. Phobos went on a world tour as a tourist. At first, he packed all his clothes inside his guitar, which caused his clothes to wrinkle and his guitar to go out of tune. He opened his act with a flourish of a magician pulling a rabbit out of a hat. People thought he was great until he opened his mouth to sing. While traveling, Phobos got a ride in a bronze-colored 65 Thunderbird. He put his own homemade tape in the cassette deck and fell asleep after one song. The driver was about to fall asleep too, when a police officer pulled him over for driving too slow. The police officer heard the songs coming out of the car window and fell asleep on his motorbike. Soon the whole freeway fell asleep. Phobos toured Norway, became ill, and had a delicate operation. After the operation, the nurses would come around on their rounds proclaiming, "He's a great Canadian folk songer." The hospital was spared his singing during his recovery. Traveling on to Switzerland, Phobos broke into song and heard what he thought was thunderous applause. But it was just an avalanche that he set off. When the avalanche died down, a crowd was still booing and jeering. With the stub of his tail between his legs, Phobos shrunk on home and became a recluse. To save his face, he'd make up excuses, such as yodeling is for humans, not us guys. Phobos got a job catching flies with his brother Deimos' exterminating company. By this time, Deimos was only dastardly towards termites and the like, and was kind to his own kind. Eventually, Phobos lost interest in singing, got married, and had a whole mess of polywogs. Every one of those little tadpoles took music lessons with an opera queen, and the mill pond resounded with the sound, a beautiful yodeling chorus. That was a slightly embellished story. The species of the characters has been changed. I am the voice of Stefan's imaginary friend. You can call me Deimos, named after one of the moons of Mars. I know a lot of secrets about Stefan, like on the 17th of March 1976, I was witness to Stefan dressing up as a frog and performing at Fatal Bert's coffee house. Oh, is that the light? How long do I have left? 30 seconds? Well, I am Deimos, the imaginary friend of Stephen de Laurier. I encourage all of you to buy one of his books, The Yodeling Frog, and Other Atrocities at lulu.com or Symphony in a Flat Tire. Or Junkyard in the Sky, Literary Space Debris, only $129. Thank you very much, you are so kind.